It has been a long time coming. Today is the day that FilmConvert is announcing the next major upgrade to the FilmConvert suite, which is the addition of Halation. On November 20th, 2023, FilmConvert's Halation update will be available for purchase as an upgrade to your existing license or as a purchase alongside of a new license for $69, and that is in USD. What is good, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. For those of you guys who are new here, I'm Sydney Baker Green. I'm a cinematographer and colorist, and for a little over a year now, I have been working side by side with FilmConvert on this update, bringing Halation to the FilmConvert suite to just talk about the implementation before any beta or samples were created, to seeing some of the samples of their implementation at NAB behind the scenes, to working on the betas, to finally where we are at today, which is the announcement. Now, here's the deal. Working with the betas that I have been sent, one of the things that I've particularly enjoyed about their implementation of Halation from a purist perspective is the accuracy. So to give you guys a little bit of insider knowledge with respect to FilmConvert's process, they have used CineStill 800T, which is a Kodak motion picture film, turned into a 35mm C41 processed photographic film. But what's happened with this film in particular is that the rim jet layer is removed so that it's able to go through C41 processing. And the removal of this layer creates the halation effect that CineStill 800T is known for. Now, one of the things that you will notice about CineStill 800T is that where halation occurs is very specific. Sometimes using these plugins, we get halation in areas we really don't want it, and we're not able to fine tune that out. Example of halation that you guys can see in actual cinematography is from a TV show called In the Heat of the Night. And when you watch this series, you will see that halation occurs in the very brightest parts of the image. Now, I know this is something you guys have heard before, but when it comes to the plugins, I'm sure you guys have also experienced the difficulty of really being able to isolate those brighter portions of the image without getting halation in unwanted places. One of the other things I really appreciate about the show is that we find that halation isn't always that red bloom. A lot of the times we see halation taking on the color of the light that is being emitted onto the photographic plane of the film, or in this case with our emulations, the sensors. And so with this knowledge from a purist perspective, going into DaVinci Resolve and using the FilmConvert plugin has really shown a lot of ease in emulating those effects that we see on TV shows or movies where halation is actually present. Using the source exposure slider, we're really able to dial in where that halation is taking place in our image. And then using the strength slider, we're really able to define how much of that halation we are going to have. And then when it comes into the color control, such as the green strength or the hue, we're really able to make sure that we're matching the color of that halation to the source of the light. And another really great addition to this update is the ability to turn off the individual sections now within FilmConvert. So if you have a project that does not require a film emulation, but you want to use the halation feature, you will be able to do that as well. And vice versa, if you don't want to use halation at all, but you want to use the film emulation aspect of FilmConvert. There's a couple of things that I would like to see possibly added before the release or alongside an update after the release. That's just some ease of use things, right? For example, I know what colors are specifically in that hue range when you're using it on a slider, but perhaps a little rainbow of the colors so that you can very quickly go into what hue you want when you're making that adjustment would be awesome for those people who are beginners. And then to just have even more options, which allow us to really define where our light source is or what areas of the image we want the halation on as well. I know there's only so much you can do, but I'm not a developer and that's the reason they are. So if we could have access to those tools, that would be awesome as well. On November 20th or somewhere around that time, but I'm pretty sure on the 20th, I will be bringing you guys a full-on tutorial on how to use this halation feature. Until then, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. You guys know the deal. Comment, rate, and subscribe. If you already have not, turn on those post notifications. Follow me on social media. The links are in the description down below. And now, more than ever, friends, if you are ever feeling uninspired, uncreative, or just want to give up on life, every day, airplanes take off against the wind. Keep climbing, stay inspired, and as always, stay fabulous. I'm Sydney. I'll see you beautiful people next time. Peace out.